Hello everyone, welcome you all in this video lecture. So in today's video, we are going to discuss about an important cell organelle which is named as lysosomes. So before moving to the topic, let's understand some introductory part and some basic facts about the cell and the cellular organelles. So the cell is defined as the basic structural and functional unit of any cellular organism. So all the cellular organisms except viruses are made up of cells, and they can be unicellular and multicellular. So the cell is the unit of any cellular life, and cell is composed of different types of cellular organelles. It is composed of an aqueous compartment, which is also called as cytoplasm, and it is bound by a plasma membrane, which is a semi-permeable membrane. So the cells are of two types, they are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. And the eukaryotic cell is properly modified cell which have several membrane bound cytoplasmic organelles, and the prokaryotic cell lack these membrane bound cellular organelles. So the eukaryotic cell contain endoplasmic reticulum, lysosome, mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, vacuoles, proper nucleus, and many other cellular organelles. And these cellular organelles are responsible for different types of functions for the cell. So in this video lecture, we are going to discuss about an important cell organelle named as lysosome. So the lysosomes are also defined as specialized vesicles, and these vesicles are small spheres like structure which are filled with a fluid and surrounded by a lipid bilayer membrane, and they are single membrane organelles. So these organelles are found in the cytoplasm of eukaryotic cell, but lysosomes are not found in prokaryotic cells. The lysosomes are enclosed by the tissue dissolving or hydrolytic enzymes, and these hydrolytic enzymes made the nature of lysosome acidic. So basically, lysosomes are only found in animal cells, and they are not found in plant cell and prokaryotic cell. But sometimes in some plant cell, they can be found. Now let's understand about the discovery and history of lysosomes. So lysosomes were first discovered by Christian de Duve in 1949, but he named them as a societal bags of the cell. After some time, in 1955, they were named as lysosomes. Now let's understand about the location of lysosome. So lysosome is found in the cytoplasm of the cell, and it is embedded in the cytoplasm and called as cytoplasmic organelle. Basically, they are small sphere vesicle-like structures which are filled with different types of digestive hydrolytic enzymes. And they are also responsible for the digestion and different types of other functions in the cell. So here in this picture, it is a picture of the anatomy of animal cell which having different types of cellular organelles or cytoplasmic organelles. So here we can see the plasma membrane of the cell embedded, and at the core of this cell we can see the nucleus. And here in the cytoplasm of the cell, there are different types of cytoplasmic organelles like endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, Golgi bodies, and here these spheres, which are indicating lysosomes. So this is the location of lysosome in the cell. So now let's understand about the structure and chemical composition of lysosome. So as we have discussed earlier, that the lysosome is a membrane bound organelle, and it have a single membrane. So inside this single membrane, the structure or the area is called as lumen, and the lysosomes are generally very small organelles which are ranging in size from 0.1 to 0.5 micrometer, and sometimes some larger sizes. Now the lysosome have a lumen, and this lumen contains hydrolytic enzymes and many other cellular debris. And the matrix contains tissues which are dissolving enzymes or hydrolysis and many other acidic phosphatases. So basically, the important enzymes of lysosome are nucleases, phosphatases, proteases,
sulfatases, lipase, lysozyme, and many other enzymes. And these enzymes are responsible for the digestion of many cellular wastages, which can done by lysosome. The lysosome is very acidic in nature, and the pH of the lumen of acid lysosome lies between 4.5 to 5.0 pH normally. So here in this diagram we can see the structure of lysosome. So here we can see the spherical structure having lipid bilayer, and outside we can see different types of transport proteins which carry all the waste material or all the materials to the lysosome. And inside the lipid layer we can see the lumen of lysosome, which is containing different types of hydrolytic enzymes and different types of mixture of enzymes, which is responsible for the digestion of all the waste. Now let's understand that why lysosomes are known as suicidal bags. So as we have discussed earlier, that lysosomes are also called as suicidal bags. And how and why they called as, let's understand. So basically the lysosome work as a waste discarding structure of the cell, and they are known as a digesting structure. So basically they degrade all the undesirable materials from exterior of the cell and as well as from the interior of the cell. And for this function they release different types of digestive enzymes like hydrolases and many other enzymes, and these enzymes have the ability to digest all the cell materials, all the waste material, and sometimes whole cell. And this digestion leads to the cell death, because they sometimes when the cells are damaged due to some infections or many other reasons, then lysosome perform the autolysis and burst open and the cell is damaged. So that's why they are known as suicidal bags, because they damage its own cell. So that's why the reasons behind the lysosomes called as suicidal bags of the cell, because they have the ability to digest the cells. So now let's understand the functions of lysosome. So there are many important functions which are performed by lysosomes, and they consist of two types, which are heterophagy and autophagy. So as their name indicates, the heterophagy means digestion of external particles which are from exterior of the cell or outside of the cell. So basically these enzymes have the ability to catalyze the breakdown of different types of polysaccharides, proteins, and nucleic acid molecules. And that's why they help in the intracellular digestion of all the foodstuffs. So basically this is found in different types of unicellular organisms like protozoans, sponges, and many other organisms where digestive system is not found. So in that organisms, the lysosome perform the digestion of foodstuff. And that's why it is called as heterophagy, because these are the materials from outside of the cell. Now the another type is autophagy, which means that the digestion of internal particles of the cell. So basically in that condition the lysosome help in the removal of dead and decaying cells or tissues, and sometimes some organelles of the tissues. Here the lysozymes of these cells become enlarged and later they fractured. And this is known as autophagy, or sometimes also called as autolysis. And in that condition the complete cell is digested, and that's why they are called as suicide bags, because they digest own cell. So now let's understand the significance of lysosomes, or what is the importance of lysosomes in the cell. So as we have discussed that they play a very important role in the digestion. So they have the role for the lysis of organelles or digestion of organelles during cellular differentiation and metamorphosis. And they have also function of removal of exhausted cells by the process of autophagy or autolysis. Lysosome also help in the defense against invading bacteria and viruses by macrophagy. And they can digest the yolk during embryonic development, and also they can perform the bone resorption. And there are many other significance, like they have the ability to chromosomes breaks which are caused by ruptured lysosomes. and they have also some significances like the nutrition by autophagy during cellular degeneration under special conditions. So these are some very important importance of lysosomes in our cells. Now the dysfunctioning of lysosome or many defects of lysosome caused many diseases in the organisms, and these diseases are combinedly called as lysosome storage diseases, and there are many other diseases like silicosis and rheumatoid arthritis. The silicosis is the disease which is caused in mainly industrial workers which are working in silica related areas. So in that condition, the lungs are infected and the hydrolytic enzymes of lysosome cause damage. In the condition of rheumatoid arthritis, it is an inflammatory disease of body joints, and it is caused by the release of lysosomes enzymes from the cell into the extracellular space, which cause damage to the material, because we know that lysosome contain very acidic hydrolytic enzymes. They have the ability to digest the cell and many other cellular organelles.